Pastor Welton Lane here, the pastor of the Family Worship Center. God is up to something at the Family Worship Center. He's a supplier of all your needs. Why don't you plan to come and join us in worship?
You're always welcome to come worship with us at Family Worship Center. Be encouraged. Jesus loves you, and so do we.
You know, our scripture is going to come from Psalms chapter 30. It says, I will exalt thee, O Lord, for thou hast lifted me up and hast not made my foe to rejoice over me. O Lord, my God, I cry unto thee. Thou hast healed me. O Lord, thou hast brought my soul from the grave. Thou hast kept me alive that I should not go down to the pit. Sing unto the Lord, O ye saints of his, and give thanks at the remembrance of his holiness. You know, we have something to praise God for. We got something to praise God for. Have you ever been healed? Have you ever just been, have you just woke up this morning? We got something to thank God for. Hallelujah, you got the activities of your limbs this morning. Hallelujah, you got to, you can think in your right mind. You got something to praise God for. Standing.
Fill this void and
You may take your seat. Oh, come on, give him some more praise. Thank you, Jesus. I know I don't deserve the way Jesus loved me. Thank you, Lord. And I don't love him back the way I should. But he forgives, he's just that kind of Savior, oh Lord. And he spent most of his time saving souls like mine and yours. Come on. I know loving you and me, it can't be easy. He'll be better off with someone that's true. But he loves me 'cause he's just that kind of Savior. Oh yes, he is, Roger. And he spent most of his time saving souls like mine and yours. Oh Lord, yeah. I never heard say, Welton, you gone too far to find your way back to the fold. Oh Lord, but he forgives, he's just that kind of Savior. Oh, yes, he is. He spent most of his time saving souls like mine. Come on, somebody, give him some praise. I know loving you and me, it can't be easy. With someone that's new, yeah. But he forgives, he's yes, that kind of Savior. Oh, yes, he is. And he spends most of his time saving souls like mine. Come on, give him some praise. He spent most of his time saving souls like mine. Yeah. Oh, Lord, yeah. Thank you, Jesus. Know that I'm not worthy. Call upon your name. All my life I've been a sinner. Lord, for this I'm ashamed. But I heard that you would listen, so I'm begging you, please. You're unworthy to come to you. Would you please come down to me? Oh, that there are others Who can offer more than I? Long you'll all understand. You're for me, you had no time. Yes, I just hit bottom and I'm looking up to see you're unworthy, Lord, to come to you. Would you please come down to me?
Give him a praise, somebody. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, I must be reaping from the seeds I've sown. Lord, owe me nothing. We haven't talked for so long. You can spare some mercy, Lord, please. To unworthy, Lord, come to you. Would you please come down to me? Lord, there are others who can offer more than I. Promise you I'll understand. If for me you had no time. Yes, I just hit my world and I'm looking up to see. You're unworthy, Lord, to come to you. Would you please come down to me?
Give him praise, somebody.
As I just hit my arm, yeah, looking up to see, yeah. You're unworthy, Lord, to come to you. Would you please come down to me? Come down to me.
Oh, come on, give him a praise. Would you rest upon your feet?
Father, for your glory, just your glory. Lord, for your glory, get all the glory. We're here to say thank you for what you have already done, and thank you for what you're doing right now, and thank you for the big plans that you have for your sons and your daughters. Now, Father, we need you to anoint us to hear what you have to say to us today. Lord, we hear with an open heart. Write on the tablet pages of our heart what you want us to hear, what you want us to do. And, Father, for your glory, when the enemy come after church is over to steal the word, he cannot steal the word that you have put in our heart, because it become a part of our heart, because it is you who write the words on the tablet pages of our heart. And I thank you for that. Get all the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Clap your hands and shout yes. Yes to his will. And I declare yes to his way. Shout his way. Amen. Come on, give the Lord another praise up in here.
Amen. Amen.
Tell somebody, have a hearing ear today. Because this message is for you and me. I want to talk to you this morning about one of the worst, one of the deadliest sin there is. How many know there's so many sins? I mean, it just takes one, really, to mess you up. Talk to me. Well, it's just, I don't think God is that kind of God would send somebody to hell for just a white lie. What color is a lie? A lie is a lie, and a lie don't have color.
Y'all need to talk back to me. And see, one lie could put your soul in hell. Just one. Huh? Hold on a minute. I'm finna get deeper than that. If you could believe one lie and put your soul in hell. Listen. If you steal that car, you can get away with it. And if I believe that, I get in the driver's seat, I watch bait car. And I get in the driver's seat and go down the road and end up in an accident. Where you going? You're sure not going to heaven. I stole the car. I believed the lie that said I can get away with it. I believed the lie. And the lie that I believed and manifested me still in the car, and into eternity I go with a stolen car. See, it's not just telling a lie could mess you up. It's believing a lie. Well, I wish I had a witness right here. Can I just take my time and talk to you? You may take your seat, take your seat, take your seat. Did you hear the story about the woodpecker? You didn't? You didn't? That was picking away on the trunk of a dead tree. I mean, he was growing up in Texas, right on the outside of my window. Woodpeckers just, I mean, they'd be double teaming. Like they're beating the drum, pecking into the tree. But suddenly, as he was pecking into this dead tree, lightning struck. And lightning struck the tree, and the tree fell with all kind of noise. And the woodpecker flew away unharmed. He turned around and looked at the tree and said, "Whoa, look what I've done. What a tree." And then he added, "What a beak." He thought it was his pecking that splintered the tree. Y'all, come on. The woodpecker remind me of some people who think, I mean, throughout history, they think of their own greatness, their own might, their own power, and they don't want to give the glory to Almighty God. Talk to me. Amen. Pride is one of the worst things that the devil have going for the saints. Wait a minute. For the who? For the saints. Come on. He know he can't get you to get out there and act a fool for the devil. Get no friends. He know he can't get you to go out there and nightclubbing and drink and shoot up dope and do everything that you little enough to do. But he'll plant the seed of pride in your spirit. One of the most, it bypass anger, it bypass greed, it bypass drunkenness, it bypass so many sins. But this is one of the most dangerous sin that's going today. Pride. It is the cause of misery throughout the nation. Throughout homes, somebody let the spirit of pride move in and dwell. No, I don't want that, do you? Amen. And, you know, a lot of time I like an example. Don't you like an example sometimes? Here's an example. Somebody you can see. Somebody you could look at what it cost them
And when you can see what it costs them, there's a commercial about cigarette smoking. It's a little woman that come on and she put her hair on and she take her hair off and then she take off her makeup and then she uncover the hole in her throat. And it's really sad. And why is that commercial on there? It's to show you what cigarette smoking costs. It's good for you and I to have an example to look at and see what it costs somebody to go in the direction that they are going. And that ought to be enough to shake us and wake us and make us say, I don't want to take that avenue because I don't want to go through what they're going through. Y'all looking at me funny. I don't want to go through what they're going through. Now, for an example here's an example. King Nebuchadnezzar, he had a lot to teach us about pride and the destruction nature of pride. Are you in the house? In fact, come go with me to Daniel, the 4th chapter, the 30th verse. Clap your hands and give God some praise. Shout hallelujah. Anyhow, praise God. Now, this man is the king. I mean, he was so full of himself. See, when you're full of yourself, you don't have room for God. There's no room for God because you're taking up all the space. Pride will take over your life if you let it. It will change you if you let it. Is there a witness in here? Let's look at this king. Let's begin reading at the 30th verse. Let's listen what he had to say. The king spake and said, Is this not great Babylon that I built for the house of the kingdom by the might of who power? My power, and for the honor of my majesty. He is full of pride. Is this not, he'd look back at his city and say, is this not the city that I built with my power, with my might, with my education, with my wisdom, with my knowledge and my understanding? My life that I have built, look at what I've done. Are you in the house? It's easy to see what you have done and get off focus and not realize if it had not been for the Lord who kept my breath in my nose. If it had not been for the Lord being on my side, David put it this way, where would I be? Somebody. And see, a lot of time we could easily get caught up in that if we're not prayerful. Oh, look what I have done. You haven't did anything, amen, because you have no breath of your own. You have no activities of your own. You have no wisdom of your own. It's been given to us. Is there a witness up in here anywhere? My majesty, look at the 31st verse. He's still talking. Why? Listen, you can say the wrong thing and move God in your direction. I know it don't just work in the good department. It also work in the bad department. I can say some things that will bring the presence of the Lord where I am. And therefore, prompt the song, the presence of the Lord is here. I could also open my mouth and say the wrong thing that will bring the presence of the Lord where I am. But I'd rather be in the presence of the Lord with the right words in my mouth than the presence of the Lord with the wrong words coming out of my mouth. See, God could be there to bless. He could also be there to curse. I don't like to hear that kind of preaching. Oh, but it's going to do us all good. Pride. That's what we want to talk to you about. Are you still in the house? Here's the king. Here's the king that's full of pride. Come on, read it. See, what words was in the king's mouth? What he was saying he had done. What he was bragging on himself. While his words was in his mouth. See, God don't take lightly to us our overflated in our ego. God don't take lightly to us tooting our own horn, forgetting who he is. That's what that equals. When we get so caught up in what we about, what we have done, we forget who brought us across. That's why God told Moses, go ask these folks, have they forgot who brought them across this Jordan? They forgot. And when you forgot, you begin to get on God's nerve. That's some nerves I don't want to get on.
I'm so thankful for everything you've done for me. Just to have you in my life is such a blessing. How you constantly showing me just how much you love me.